CCK King's Circle with Pastor Dr. W.F. Kumoyi.
Hi there. Welcome to the GCK King's Circle, where kings, queens, princes, and princesses are nurtured, nested, and knitted to be royal. My name is Joshua Taiwo, the host of today's episode of the GCK King's Circle. And with me is...
Unique John, the co-host of today's episode. Today's episode is brimming with juicy content to inspire you to greatness.
The convener of the GCK King's Circle is Dr. W.F. Kumoyi. Let's meet him.
Forget numbers. Dr. W.F. Kumoyi found his calling in faith. He traded formulas for the Bible. His charisma and teachings have captivated millions worldwide, making him a giant in the world of evangelism. He's not just about preaching fire. He's fueling the future through initiatives like the King's Circle, mentoring young people to become leaders who can change the world. Dr. Kumoyi isn't just a preacher. He's a force for good, empowering a generation to rise and shine.
Unique, I want to ask you a question. Are you part of the generation Dr. Kumoyi is empowering?
Of course I am. Are you?
Yes, I am. Before we listen to the powerful charge of Dr. Kumoyi, let's listen to this inspiring music.
In today's episode, Dr. Kumoyi explains the kinds of partnership vitals for one's progress.
He also stresses some precautions you should take while partnering with others for progress. Listen and be blessed.
See, when we are working, you need to have some partners that you are working with. Now, in your Christian life, you have partners, a boy to a boy, a girl to a girl. What kind of partners do we need? Number one, prayer partners. You know, there are times you want to pray, but you are kind of lazy. You're almost sleeping. But if there were two of you, a brother to a brother, a sister to a sister, and you're in partnership together, you'll be able to pray together. And if two of you shall agree as touching anything that they shall ask of the Heavenly Father, he'll do it unto them. Number two, reading partner. Now, you're having the same subject with that other sister. You're a sister yourself, and you come into partnership with that other sister, a reading partner. Number three, a study partner. We are preparing for the same term exam, or we are preparing for the same final exam. The subjects I'm taking are the subjects he's taking, and we are study partners. We're studying together. The areas I'm strong, I'm able to help him. And the areas I'm weak, he is able to help me. Number four, evangelism soul winning partners. We are winning souls together. You know, there are times when you just feel, I don't think I want to talk to anybody today. I don't think I want to go out in evangelism today. But your brother, you're a brother, or your sister, and you are a sister, comes along. And he says, let's go out. The Lord is laying it on my heart today. We need to go out and evangelize. Partners in progress. Partnership for progress. Number one, prayer partners. Number two, reading partners. Number three, study partners. Number four, evangelism or soul winning partners. Our schools and communities are populated with believers and unbelievers. Saints and sinners, righteous people and unrighteous people. When we go to school then, although we read with others, We study with others. We walk with others. And we use library books with other people. And we share our textbooks with other people. And we copy notes from other people. All the same, take these precautions. Number one, mind your own business. If tales are going around in the school, mind your own business. If they are plotting or ganging up against the teacher, mind your own business. If they are gossiping about the teacher teaching us English, mind your own business. And if they say, have you heard? Are you going to take part? Will you do this? Oh, I'm sorry. That's not what I came for. I came to school to learn. And I want to concentrate on what I came for. Number two, be friendly with your classmates and teachers. That we're Christians doesn't mean that we hate people. In fact, we love people, believers and unbelievers, and church members and non-church members. There is a level of love and friendship we manifest towards everybody that they know. They say, that young lady, she's friendly, she's nice. She doesn't go about with a gloomy, long face as if, you know, everybody has offended her. Cheerful, happy, joyful, glad. Be friendly with your classmates and teachers. Number three, do your homework and work within the syllabus. And you know, there are some people that have not finished studying what they are supposed to study, and they're studying other things outside the territory of their assignment. Work within your syllabus. Don't be distracted to other things. You know, some young people, they leave their textbooks where they are, and they go to the cyber cafe, and they're watching this and plucking this and writing this and typing this and plucking this one out and putting this one in, and they're interested in things that will ruin their lives. But you work hard on the essential things. And then do not let people steal your books. I know some nice girls, when they go to school with bag full of books, they come back home almost with an empty bag. What happened to your bag? They have stolen my books. Keep your books. There are some boys, intelligent boys, but they leave their bag where they don't ought not to leave their bag, and they are running about. By the time they come back, all the books are gone. Be very, very watchful, and do not allow other children to steal those books. Guard your resources very well. When you go to school and you happen to be born again, if it's a new school, immediately you get there, you will look for other believers like yourself, so that you'll not be a lone ranger. And you ask somebody, she's been in the school now for about 4 weeks. I will say, have you discovered any other believer? No, I didn't even check up. I just get to the class, and I read my books, and then I come out, I come back home. I've not spotted out, I've not identified any other person. Open your eyes and identify somebody like yourself, of like precious faith. And a serious sister like yourself, a serious brother like yourself, then you can be partners together in progress. Let's talk to the Lord in prayer. Talk aloud to God. You're schooling. How serious are you in the school? Do you leave home and then instead of getting to school, you branch another place? Why don't you repent today? Make up your mind. I won't choose partners that will ruin my life or destroy my life. I will not compromise my conviction. Heavenly Father, we thank you very much for today. We pray, Lord, as many as have not given their lives to the Lord Jesus Christ, there will be genuine repentance. They will confess their sins and turn away from them and be truly converted and saved in Jesus' name. Grant us your grace to begin to lay the right foundation. The future will be great for every one of us in Jesus' name. Thank you because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray.
It is important to note that even though you interact with others and partner with them for the sake of progress, be cautious and avoid activities that will undermine the purpose of God for your life.
Thank you for joining us on the King's Circle today. Do join us for another inspiring time with Dr. Kumuyi. Till we meet again, be a world changer for Christ.
We believe that you've been impacted. Pastor Dr. W.F. Kumuyi would love to hear from you. Please visit our social media platforms. And don't forget to join us on the next episode of GCK King's Circle.